The following video features one of Georgia's exceptional teachers demonstrating engaging, research-based, and standards-based instruction in an authentic Georgia classroom. This video series is intended to help instructional leaders identify lessons and strategies used in the classroom that help students master the standards. As you watch the videos, please notice the instructor's best practices along with the appropriate student behavior that are reflected in the standards-based classroom instructional framework.
So my name is Zach Kirk, and this is Hampton High School, located in the Henry County School District. The class that you were able to witness and see is an 11th grade American Literature and Composition course, with some of the students taking the option for honors and some students taking the option for advanced placement and some students simply taking the college prep route. Students were given a choice of four different roles, or rather assigned one of four roles. Students were either selected to be the mother of Anthony Stokes, advocating for her son to have the heart transplant. They were the doctor who was recommending the child not receive the heart transplant. They were the mother of a patient next in line for a heart transplant who had actually done and complied with doctor's orders, or they were an SCLC advocate advocating on behalf of the Stokes family. So each student was given one of those four roles in their groups, and they had to really make a point or an argument for that. They were assigned a role based on the opposite of what they believed so that they would thoroughly be able to provide a claim and a counterclaim and know both in the actual writing portion of the assignment. All right, guys, we are now ready to begin. What you are going to do is you need to transfer notes from your anchor book to your note card, because that's what you will use in your debate time. I'm going to give you an additional 5 minutes. For your role, your time starts now.
And who's to say when he does get the new heart, he's not going to take care of his body? You can't say what the future holds. You can't say how he's going to live.
Well, it's not necessarily living in fear, because if you want something, then you're going to take care of it. It's not living in fear. You're still going to not necessarily eat what you want to eat, but you're just going to eat better and do better because you want to keep it.
So before we go into the actual debate part, now that you've gathered your evidence and you've looked closely at your two sources, I want everyone in each group to put your group member's name straight down in the column of the rubric. And we're going to talk about how I'm going to evaluate your conversation or your debate. I'm going to walk around. I'm listening for key things. Remember, I'm looking for the fact that you are now prepared to have the debate. I'm listening for each person to give me the evidence that supports the claim that you're making as the doctor, as the mother of Anthony Stokes, as the mother of the patient next in line for the transplant, or as the SCLC advocate fighting on behalf of the Stokes family. Make sure that you're bringing evidence into your debate. I'm also looking for the fact that you keep the conversation going, that you use the full time allotted for what your task is. In the third part of the lesson, students were given the actual writing prompt, where they had to draw from the article from the AJC and the article from the medical journal, and they had to bring those two articles together in the same way that they would use for an extended response on Georgia milestones. Then they would have to make meaning, and they would have to cite their sources adequately for a full score. All those things we've talked about in class and practice with, but this really brought that home for our kids right before they actually go into the real assessment. So now that we have concluded our debates, we are ready to move into some really strong, really good, rigorous writing. We're going to do an extended argumentative response that's going to use two sources. In order to write a really strong, extended response that is argumentative in scope, what are some elements that must be present? Okay, Alyssa, I saw your hand first.
Well, some of the things you need to do is introduce your topic and stance on the argument and determine the main points for each paragraph.
Great job, Alyssa. Anybody else? What else do we need? Okay, Maja.
You not only have to support your claim, but you have to look at the opposing claims to develop a counter-argument which will better support your evidence.
Exactly what I'm looking for, Maja. Anybody else wanting to add to it? Quanasia.
In addition to writing a well-developed essay and having claims and counterclaims, you make sure you have efficient textual evidence and make sure that the audience, which is your reader, is able to read and understand what side you're more in favor of, and they're able to make a decision by the end of reading it.
You got it. So guys, what we're going to do, I need everyone to take a moment and again, look at the prompt. This extended response, should Anthony Stokes be given a life-saving heart transplant, is mirrored after exactly what you're going to see on the Georgia Milestones Assessment in section 3, Day two, extended response. And so again, use both of the articles that we've read, understanding non-compliant behavior, definitions and causes, and hospital rejects teen for heart transplant list. And then you're gonna use those two articles, pulling your sources, use your anchor books to write the best essay you can. You have 40 minutes and 40 minutes only. Are there any final questions? All right, guys, let's get it done. Your time starts now. When our students are having to grapple with complex texts and having to write under time constraints, it's really important to give them some strategies they can use. And it's not giving them a lockstep, you have to do this every single time, but it gives them an entryway into being able to formulate a response in a timely fashion. So what we've used here is the race strategy, that students restate the question, they provide an answer, they cite specific evidence from the text, and then they give commentary or an explanation for that evidence. I found that it's been very effective in having our students give really good, strong responses under time constraints.
Please note, this is a snapshot of effective instructional practices in one classroom, and effective instruction varies with the standards and lessons. For more examples and resources, view the other videos in the series and visit GeorgiaStandards.org.